Namaskara. I am Dr. Harihara Murthy. I am practicing in Bangalore at Murthy ENT Center in Koramangala for about 3 decades now. Nasal obstruction can be there for multiple reasons. One of the most common reasons for nose block is deviation of the nasal septum. The middle wall of the nose can be bent to one or the other side because of excessive bone growth, as a result of which you can have deviated septum causing obstruction. Apart from that, injuries to the nose can also cause the same deviations and can cause obstruction. Increase in size of the tissues in the nose, we have rolls of tissue called turbinates on either side of the nasal cavity on the outer wall, which can sometimes become very large, ballooned out, as a result of which they can cause obstruction and you can have nasal blockage. Apart from that, you can have polyps which grow in the nose. Sometimes there is a breach in the roof of the skull and you have meningiomas, which are extensions from the brain coming into the nasal cavity causing obstructions. The most common in children between 2 and 4 years of age, or even afterwards, going into adulthood sometimes, is adenoid hypertrophies. Adenoids, which are like the tonsils situated in the back of the nose, these adenoids can increase in size and cause obstruction, which invariably comes down after 4 years of age and sometimes in rare situations can continue into adulthood. So there are multiple reasons why you can have obstructions in the nose. Invariably, a bad cold can cause a nasal obstruction because the tissues swell up like any other part of the body. When there's an infection, there's a swelling up of tissues. So you can have a swelling of tissues causing it. Now, this is distinct from abnormal situations. A cold is usually self-limiting. If you take medicines, in a week it will go. If you don't take medicines, in 7 days it will go. So it depends on how much you want to suffer. If you take medicines, your symptoms are going to be taken care of and it will settle down. We don't have the luxury of taking off from work or reducing our work through the week. So we have to take medicines to make sure we tide over the period of the infection. So medicines will relieve this problem. But then the former conditions that I mentioned, like deviation of septum, polyps, etc., they have to be treated only surgically. The infections can be eminently treated with medication. Make sure you met your physician and got the right diagnosis made so that you get the right treatment and you are relieved of the problem. It's difficult to live life with a blocked nose. You can't breathe in the day, you can't breathe in the night, your sleep will get disturbed. So make sure the right diagnosis is made and then you can get the treatment for it.